We're flying from San Francisco to Seattle, and I'm about to send a drink and a private message to a complete stranger.
Here we go. Classic cab is going to 4F. I'm sending her a message. Good morning, America. Just sent you a drink. Here we go. Send. Fingers crossed.
The message doesn't scare her, which is good because she's sitting right next to me. The wine is well received, and I find out that seat 4F is Diane Siebold, and she likes Virgin America's new pickup tool, which, by the way, my wife has given me permission to use just this once.
It's a little unusual, but it's kind of cool.
Let's face it, flying is far better known for lost luggage than love, a tool of misery and frustration, not generally known as a place to hit on people. And that's despite this textbook example from the movie Bridesmaids.
Uh-oh. What's that?
I gotta get back to my seat.
Virgin wants to rewrite the cliches and really be a place where love is in the air.
Virgin America, if an airline can be sexual, this is a sexual airline. You know, they try to be sexy. They try to push the limits.
Every seat comes with a screen that lets you send a drink and a text message to anyone just by seat number. We found plenty of women and men who were more than a little interested.
I'm not going to say no to a Bloody Mary.
I mean, why not? At least you're both interested in travel.
But here's the thing. Once airborne, there's no place to hide, no fake phone call to take, no sorry I'm late and have to run.
I think that's a little creepy.
A little creepy?
Yeah.
Virgin says not to worry. You can always turn the system off. And who knows, a flight delay could even turn out to be perfect. After all, misery loves company. For Good Morning America, Neil Karlinski, ABC News, at 38,000 feet.
So what do we think? We think that Neil has a very understanding wife.
Yeah.